So the Spartan 2s were the first ones created. They were named the Spartan 2s because obviously they were already Spartan 1s. They fought in the movie 300 and fought against Xerxes. So the Spartan 2s were children stolen by Dr. Halsey and some of the government, top secret government members that stole children at the ages of like, you know, 6 to 8 or 9 that they thought had the genetic makings to handle some of their tests and their super soldier serums and their augmentations that they were going to make to these children. And what they did so that the parents wouldn't notice that the kids were missing was they cloned those kids, and the clones could only survive for a year. So unfortunately, the parents did get an extra year with what they thought was their kids, but those kids all died a year later of various ailments because they were clones. And then those children grew up to be Master Chief and Fred and Linda and Tanaka and all the Spartan 2s here.
She knows your forgotten name. Who you were before you were 117.
Knowledge says my favorite Halo is Reach and 5. Nice, Knowledge. Nice. Well, I'm talking about the backstory of some of this universe, so if I missay anything, feel free to correct me in the chat. I could definitely use some backup, especially from someone who likes this game too. So Cortana obviously programmed these Forerunners and this technology, these Wardens, to protect her, but also to lead Master Chief to her as well. So there's something going on there that we're going to start getting to the root of. But he mentioned that Cortana knows who John really is, knows who his real name is before he became John 117, which has never been discussed or talked about in any of the extended universe stuff. So they are trying to, with Master Chief's story in this game, they are definitely trying to get further, go into the root of who he is as a man, which they set up in 4. Which we talked about before, where Halo 1, 2, and 3 felt more like a weapon who just followed orders, just a grunt, an exceptional grunt. But in 4 and 5, they're actually adding humanity to him. So it's really fun. So the Spartan 2s were... hold on, let me catch up in the chat here. September 22nd was the same day the double soundtrack for RE3 was released. Hell yeah, it was. Nice, good memory. RE3, oh, Res Evil. I guess that's okay-ish. It's super okay-ish. I can't even get enough conviction on that to complete the word guess. Aw, CB. I know there's not a lot of love for... that's why I'm surprised Joe mentioned that. He's not a big Res Evil 3 fan. LOL, you would be right. Halo 1 mostly takes place on September 22nd. CB. nice. He has feelings. September 22nd, 2552. That's right. Look at that. Balazar with some knowledge, too.
Sweet.
Very, very cool. So the Spartan 2s, so they grew up. There was 70 or 80 of them were created, but only about half of them survived the experiments and the enhancements and everything. So, and one of those obviously was this team here and Master Chief. And that's kind of his background. And Dr. Halsey really is kind of a monster, in my opinion, stealing children, cloning them. And the reason she created them wasn't to fight aliens. She created them to fight humans. Humanity at this point in the universe had, inhabited over almost 800 planets. But they really only conquered 2, Reach and Earth. That's where the most of humanity was. But on most of these planets, like Meridian and the planet we were just on, there's maybe like 1 or 2 settlements there. Not a lot of people on most of these planets. And a lot of them didn't like the Oni Corporation, who had kind of been overseeing all these, inhabitants of these planets, and started coming up with all these rules and these united, they're kind of like a UN, coming up with all these United Planets rules. And a lot of people didn't like that. So the insurrectionists rose and a civil war broke out between humanity. So the Spartans were originally created to kill the insurrectionists, to kill humans. And what ended up happening is basically on the eve of the Spartans being sent to kill humans, the Covenant attacked. And then instead of the Spartans and Master Chief and all of them being sent to wipe out humans, they came to, human aid, basically. And that's kind of what led into Halo 1 for the most part, and the Forward Unto Dawn movie. You gotta check that out. It gives you a really good indication on the background of humanity and where they stand. And you follow Lasky as a young man through the Corbulo Academy, where he is, learning to not... He doesn't want to turn into just a weapon. He doesn't want to turn into just a gun to be aimed at enemies. And it shows him struggling as a young man to figure out what kind of man he wants to be. And he ultimately makes some good choices and becomes a, you know, a friend to Master Chief and quite a good leader, if I do say so myself. Oh shit, they teleport away. What's up? What's up, bitch? Suck it, Trebek. Taking your gun. September 22nd, Illuminati. Wow. Illuminati. Oh shit. Where you at? Oh, you way up there, yo. He's done. Whoa, the guy at the end of Nugget Bridge was a Team Rocket operative. Oh, shit. That's our... Well, you're dressed in silver. You look just like him. Not to sound racist. All silver armored people look alike. It doesn't look like we're gonna... Let's just lure him out, guys. No, stop doing that with the things. Let's see if we have spoiler alerts, man. Sorry, many haven't played Pokemon Yellow. Yep. I don't mind, but there are definitely some Pokemon fans in here. That's for sure. Is he dead yet? Did I kill him? Waste all my bullets? Bastards. Get your copy now on eBay for $173. I had all three when I was a kid. Nice. Yeah, I had, I just had red and blue. But Yellow, I remember when it came out, I remember everyone, all my friends were freaking out.
Your time has passed, glorious servant. Your battle fought and done.
You hear how this guy talks to me? My time has passed. Is that why I'm kicking everyone's ass, dude? Oh, shit. Oh, he's not fucking around now. He's trying to prove our worthiness. Oh, what's up? That's a Promethean Knight. Oh, shit. Suck it, Trebek. Sorry, I had to step away and make sure our temporary adopted dog was okay. Ah, no problem, Joe. I'm glad you returned safely. What are you doing? Boom! That sounds terrible the way I put it, but I don't know how else to say it. It's okay, dude. You know, I didn't even think about it when I read it, but that's funny. Yeah, that seems important, Joe. Nice, Balazar. What's up, ugly? Yeah!
Get up.
You suck. Holy shit. Got you with a bomb, yo. Oh, he's healing him. Fucking watcher. Uh, These guardians are badass. Well, the guardians is the big thing in the sky. That's not a guardian. That's a warden. And that's a Promethean knight. So that big guy with the sword, that's a warden. Guardians are badass, but we are not ready for a guardian. Not yet, anyway. Oh, shit. Oh, we're out of bullets. Pick that up. Pick it up, yo. There we go. Oh no, that's empty. All right.
Chief, hello.
Whew. Joe, now Chief didn't have to fight these wardens, right? So this warden in particular.
I can't believe you're here.
He was. Where are we? He's testing us. It's not like a.
Designation.
Cortana ordered the warden to, you know, bring us here, and he's supposed to show us to Cortana.
You know him.
But so we haven't defeated him. He's still around. He just after you weaken him, he teleports away. So yeah, exactly. See, he's a hive mind. He's like Ultron, basically. Whoops, that warden looks badass. No, he is. But he's testing us. So there's... I won't say there's no hatred from him towards us, but I think he is just, you know, trying to prove... have us prove ourselves, basically. I have a... taking suggestions. Oh, Bowser says Bulbasaur. Charmander all the way. Nice. Begrudgingly butter-free.
Just like I knew you would. Just one more to go.
Alright. Let's go. How do we get... I would like to get over to you. That would be pretty begrudging, CB says. He's the only reason I beat Brock. yeah, but that, but Balazar, what you're saying, yeah, that warden dude, he doesn't mess around.
You're so
but
close to where I am. Come on.
He's kind of a. Kind of testing us.
Okay,
I think, if I'm remembering correctly. But he definitely attacks Spartan Locke. He doesn't conversate with Spartan Locke and his crew. That's for sure. He goes right for him.
Think he needs to protect you from
but yeah, the warden's kind of like Ultron. He has a million bodies, but one mind, which just makes him really deadly and hard to kill.
Means AIs can be immortal.
No, the warden is
kind of lifespan.
The warden is totally bad.
Planning, just like the Forerunners were capable of. AIs can assume the Forerunners' mantle of responsibility. Once there is peace, we can focus on.
And the
poverty,
reason why?
Hunger, illness.
Is because listen to what Cortana's saying right
warden
now.
Warden believes some will resist our help, and he's afraid you're one of them.
Sounds great. I don't get why anyone's expecting resistance.
Didact made it clear the mantle of responsibility was an imperial piece.
Echo.
Step out of line and suffer.
It won't be like that,
yeah.
John. I'll explain it better once we're together.
So Cortana, or this fragment of her, or if it is even Cortana, is, you know, thinking like, you know, the way the wardens, I should say, the wardens are programmed by the Didact. You know, they have his level of thinking. So it's basically like fall in line or get destroyed. And what Cortana has tapped into with Forerunner technology is that she has a way to bring, you know, cure diseases, end poverty, you know, basically enhance humanity in a way to where they don't need things really, you know, to survive. And although that may sound great on paper, it also can be quite frightening and scary to a lot of people who don't want to be like the Borg, essentially. So the wardens are existing to basically
let's go
kill anyone that resists, And he, although Cortana is ordering him to not hurt us, he does believe that we will. He knows our history. He knows our interaction with the Didact. He knows we don't just fall in line, and especially anymore. Master Chief isn't just a weapon. That's why it's so important for him to evolve as a character in these later games, because the enemies he's up against, they want a world where things just fall in line. And Chief isn't that kind of guy anymore. So let's pilot one of these, ships.
As Forerunner systems go.
Yeah, look at this. We're flying our Forerunner ship. What makes us go up? Nope. There we go. Left to evade, right to evade.
Watch the fire from those turrets.
Working on it. There we go. Where is it? Where's the last one at? Oh, wait, we got some enemies over here. So some of our team goes by foot, which is pretty cool. And we cruise around in these awesome Phaeton ships. I have a Mega Bloks of this ship, actually. It's a really cool set. If you guys actually, if you ever want to buy the Halo Mega Bloks, if you ever want to start, I would start right now. I think this week, like tomorrow might be the last day. They're 40% off at Toys R Us. I'm too broke to buy any of the new ones, unfortunately, but they have these Phaeton ships and some of the other ones on sale right now for 40% off, which is a killer deal. So if you guys ever, if you like building, I work at Lego, so I know it's not, I'm not really, probably shouldn't promote Mega Bloks. But I can't help it. I love Halo, so I gotta buy all the Mega Bloks. These ships look amazing in the game. I have this game and I've yet to play through it. Oh man, we gotta play through it on co-op then, dude, on Xbox if you want. This game's fun on co-op.
Nice flying. We're starting to get the hang of this.
Can't do Mega Bloks. Pains the soul, Balazar said. Ah, yeah. I hear ya. Well, I will say this. I don't have fun building Mega Bloks. They're not fun to build. The instructions are awful. I can't. I can't deal with building them. That's why I usually... So I have some upcoming YouTube videos where I'm going to be reviewing some sets that I got. I got a Halo 4 set my mom got me for Christmas. And I won't do a speed build of it because they're not fun to build. The instructions always are misleading. They get colors of parts wrong. They miss a lot of parts. Most sets I've bought and have missed parts. So I don't like building Mega Bloks, but I love the final product. I love how they look. They are dead on. They match exactly what, like this ship here, the Mega Block version is identical to this thing. It is super awesome. They make new parts all the time, Mega Bloks, which is something Lego doesn't do often. But Legos are more fun to build. I have a lot of fun building Legos, Lego sets. I do not with Mega Block though.
All turrets down. Nice shooting.
But I like the way they look when they're done. I can't step on a Mega Block same way I step on a Lego. Mega Blocks and fun don't go together. Nice. What I missed out? Oh, Dallas, what is up? Welcome to the stream, Dallas. You guys gonna watch y'all on my phone until sleep comes and drags me away. Alright. Oh shoot, we gotta save our friends.
System's locked.
You're still active, Fred.
Thanks, I'm back.
Nice, alright. Sorry, I had to get out and save them. I didn't realize they were pinned down. Because they can die. If you don't save them in time, they'll die. Oh, John Lee, sweet dreams if you slip off. Nice. Yes. Moobot, thank you very much for the update. Oh, we were supposed to go here anyway. Okay. do this. Preemptive night-night. Absolutely. John Lee, if you drift into sleep,
is that where the gateway is?
Have a great night.
Almost there.
And thank you for being here all day today with us. Thanks for saying happy birthday to my mom like 12 or 13 times. That was really awesome of you, too.
There it is.
The gateway to the Forerunner domain. You'll be the first organics to enter since the fall of the Forerunners. I admit, after the crash here...
And what we're probably going to do, guys, is we're probably going to play for about another 20 minutes, or at least maybe till the end of this level, and then we're, or unless this level ends in the next 5 minutes, then we'll play one more level, and we'll call that a night for the stream. Just because I got a big day tomorrow, I got to make some YouTube videos tonight maybe, and I just want to get some sleep. Today and tomorrow are like my only days off. I work Monday through Friday at LEGO this week. 8-hour shifts. Like I got pretty much got like a full work week, which is new for me. So I may not be able to stream too much this week, but we will. I will stream when I come home from work some nights, and I'll post my schedule up tomorrow of what I'll be streaming. But we'll be playing Batman Arkham Knight for the rest for Monday onward. Tomorrow we're gonna play. We're gonna start another day stream tomorrow. So sometime in the afternoon we'll play early. We'll finish Halo 5, and then. And then on Monday, you know, we'll get into Batman Arkham Knight, which we have all the DLC, which I've never played before. So it's going to be really fun. And it, like I said, if you think I know some stuff about Halo, wait till you hear me drop Batman stuff. It's going to be a good time. Oh, man, I've got to watch Mom's stream on playback. Oh, yeah, it was fun. We played the first episode of...
What's your point?
You recommended assassinating him.
After we killed millions of our people.
So why didn't you?
I'm sorry, I blanked out. I was listening to the conversation there. But yeah, we played the first episode of Walking Dead, which was really fun. My mom picked it. We had a good time. And everyone in the chat talked to her and everything. She called me afterwards and said she had the best time ever. So thank all of you very much for making my mom's birthday really fun. She really, really loved it. Mom stream, CB said, yep, today is my mom's birthday. She lives on the other side of the country than me. I didn't have a lot of money, so I said, hey, how about I stream something? You pick the game. And we'll just, you can join the chat and you can meet my, you know, online friends. So that's what we did today. And she, honestly, she loved it. She had a great time. We told some stories, you know, from when I was younger, you know, parents love that stuff. Didn't tell too many, but just like one or two. And ultimately though, she had a great time. So everyone who was there, part of that, thank you so much. And also thank you all for going over to Joe's stream with me earlier. That was really awesome. And I know it made Joe's day. So BFFs all around. Thank you guys. Really, really appreciate it. A knowledge and K-Bob, thank you both for being followers of mine too. That brings us to 95 followers on here. So big shout out to Knowledge and K-Bob. Really, really appreciate you. Unless you want me to say it as kebab. Either way, it really, really means a lot. Thank you guys so much for following me on here. We're 5 away from 100 followers. And when we get to that point, I will definitely play an hour of a video game. No matter what night it is, when we hit 100, I'll play an hour. And I'll do my DMX impression the entire time. It'll be a lot of fun.
The Swords of Sang Helios.
Oh, thank you, Joe. You explained it already. Awesome. Hashtag fuck Halsey. Yes, absolutely. Well, now I know Dallas is in the room because there wasn't a lot of hatred towards Halsey earlier. If it makes you feel better, Dallas, Halsey is missing one arm. She was tortured by Jewel Mumdama, who was like the evil... you know, elite covenant member.
In his ranks. War has traditionally been a male's job on Sang Helios.
And now we're on the Sang Helios, which is the home planet. So this is the planet I was talking about earlier. So this one has a little bit more earthly-like features. You know, trees, all that stuff. Doesn't look as alien as, you know, the other planet did.
We need the Swords of Sang Helios, and that means we need Arbiter.
But we, 6 years ago when we were in Oni, when Locke was in Oni, he was screaming for the assassination of the Arbiter. He was like, we need to kill this motherfucker. He's causing too much problems. And now we're going to him as an ally. And obviously Master Chief and Arbiter at one point were enemies too. So it's not something new to Arbiter. He's familiar with befriending enemies. But we need his help. And they're going to explain why when we get to him. Oh, snap. Kebab is here. The Silent Assassin. Oh, what's up? I'm lurking. Dude, welcome to the chat and thank you for the follow. Everyone, shout out to Kebab or Kebab. I'll say Kebab until you say otherwise. Because there's no A in there, obviously. So everyone, give a shout out to Bob here. Really appreciate you being here, bud. And thank you so much for the follow. Hope you're having a good time tonight. I love you all. I got to head to bed. CB, so nice to meet you. Thank you for the follow. And I hope to see you in future streams. Thank you for being here.
Let the guns talk, Osiris.
But definitely have a good night. Thank you so much for being here, CB. Good night, CB. Dal says, blessings on you all. I'll be back. All right, dude. You too, man. We'll see you next time. I'll be around tomorrow. We're going to play the rest of this tomorrow. We're going to finish this level.
Who's next?
And then we're we'll get into the rest of the game tomorrow. So we're about the halfway point at the end of this level. So it's a good stopping point for sure. CB, have a good night, Joe says. And wait, female Sangheili? Yes. So now that the Arbiter is in control, he's implementing some diversity. And it's changing the Covenant on a whole, you know? Yeah, and so these guys, the reason they're attacking us, they do not follow the Arbiter. The Arbiter is hated by a lot of the Jackals and Elites and Grunts, for sure. Some of the Sangheili still side with him, but he's a minority in the Sangheili race and on Sangheilios, their home planet. He came back here to try to be diplomatic and try to unite his people under the guise of the Arbiter, since the Arbiter is so well, you know, like, liked. Like, the mantle is so well respected. So he's trying to bring peace and unity to his planet. Not really going so well.
Watch the turret.
Good try to flank it. Joe says, K-Bob, LOL.
Keep moving.
JFC lock. Yes, Dallas. I probably missed tomorrow's stream. Dang, gotta work the Seahawks game. Ah, man, I'm sorry, dude. Well, you know what? It'll be up in my archives, and it'll be up on my YouTube channel before you know it. You'll see some Halo on my channel very soon. I'm gonna spend tomorrow doing a lot of editing. There you go. Get out of there.
All clear.
You're dead.
There's a path carved into the cliffs.
Peace and unity fail. Yeah. Well, he's trying, though. He's trying not to use violence to do it. So these guys have a little pent-up aggression, and they're letting it out on us right now. There's a sword up there. See it? We gotta go get it.
Ahead. Looks like they're with the Swords of Sangheilios.
Shitensei Remau. Shitensei Rute Hade.
What's that, Vale?
Sangheili burial prayer. A warrior at birth, a warrior in death.
Arbiter's an ally, so these dead here are our brothers, as far as I'm concerned.
Agreed. Time for payback.
Alright. Do we see the female Sangheili? I believe so. I believe we do, actually. Alright, so we got the sword now. Good. Hey, what's up, Angel Rose? Everyone, shout out to Angel Rose. By the way, if you guys want to see any of the beauty that is Final Fantasy 15, definitely follow Angel Rose. She has been streaming the game, and it's beautiful looking. Absolutely beautiful looking. So definitely give her a hello and follow her if you can as well. She's good people. And Final Fantasy 15 is a gorgeous game. Just gorgeous. I'm sorry, you were saying something?
Yeah.
we'll save some of that, How scared are you? Shut up. Sit the hell down. Shit! Oh, you son of a bitch. Let's hide, let's hide. Let's heal. Just straight wrecking fools. That's right. The wrecking crew, man. We're the Joe After Work crew. We're the destroyers. And the Joe After Work crew united. We did what the Sangheili can't do. Oh, shit. We about to die. Look at that. Slow motion. How cool is that? That's a Needler. Dope. That was like nerd bullet time. Like nerdier bullet time. Get the hell off that. You better get away from me. You better die, son. You die so good. Smash it all, John Lee says. Or Dallas says. Oh, sorry. Dallas says, smash it all. Seek is destroying them. Wink, wink. Nice. Oh, puns. My good friend. Yeah, engaging.
Split up, Osiris.
All right, we're gonna go this way. What up, what up, what up, what up? Dishes confirmed. I'll be listening while I do the dishes. Dishes confirmed. Oh, here he comes. Oh, he's angry? I'm angry. Eat it. Need a new sword. Yeah. How's everyone doing? What's up, Medical? Hey, long time no see. Everyone, shout out to Medical in the chat. Welcome back, dude. We're just playing some Halo 5 action. Yo, yo, Medical. Ooh-hoo-hoo. Seek might need to aid all these dudes he's crushing. Yep, they might need some aid. Oh, show. But thank you all for being, again, thank you all for being here tonight. Thanks for hanging out with me today. Joe, so nice to get some Resident Evil on with you today. Checking that out. I'm hoping that that Resident Evil demo will come out in like the next week or two for Xbox. So that way I can play it for you guys. But for now, if you want to hear all my theories and stuff on that, you can check out my archives here, my archive videos. We just, right before we started this stream, I recorded an hour of me just talking about all my theories.
If we lose the Arbiter, reaching the Guardian at Sunion gets complicated.
Joe says, Almighty, thank you for hosting, brother. Welcome. Hope you're doing well tonight. Thank you for hosting again, dude. And Almighty's another guy you guys should follow. His streams are really fun. Super chill dude. Good time will definitely be had there as well. Terrible wording on that joke. I was supposed to include Medical, but I messed that up. Ah, it's okay. I know what you meant, dude.
These are pre-Covenant Sangheili ruins. They were already ancient history before humanity built the pyramids.
Yep.
Covenant flying in.
Well, so show some respect to your elders, motherfuckers.
Covey seemed convinced.
I really hope it does too, dude. Ah, yeah, for sure.
They'll be well on their way.
But if not, we got your stream for that. And Where's Barry? I watched Where's Barry play a little bit today too. Someone finally speaking my language. Oh yeah, all the way, yo. I'm with you till the end of the road, pal.
That building's
look at this.
Beating.
That's the Elder Council
gorgeous.
Chamber.
This game is gorgeous.
The Arbiter was there.
So Dallas, remind me. You've played this, right? You've played these games because I was like, oh, I feel like Dallas might need some backstory, but you don't though, do you? You've played all of these, I think. Space Vice says, hey, Medical Mischief. Everyone say hello to Medical. Oh shit. Ooh. That was a close one. Wait. Here we go. We're going through the basement. I have not. I have researched the hell out of them, but not gotten to play. Gotcha. Oh shit. Remember, I'm the one who lost the gaming system to- Oh, that's right. Ugh, yeah, sorry. Sorry, sword subject. Ah, shitty. Yeah, I know, right? Joe says, fuck! Tear you apart. I just got a 1070 graphics card for my PC. I'm a bit hyped. Oh, nice! Nice, dude. That is awesome. Nice, Medical.
Spartans, I'm coming to you now.
Got it, Maki. Spartans, clear the shipmaster of landing zone.
Is that clear enough? Oh.
Spirit inbound.
Better die real quick. And I'll get them again as I can. And this way they won't have any of this crap games on them. And any of his games on them. Yeah, I gotcha. Oh, show. Joe says medical. Oh, snap. I've been curious about getting one. Oh, shit. Hunters. Shit. All right, fine. You guys don't want to play. Eat shit, then.
Waiting for your all clear signal, Spartan Locke.
Working on
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I know. We're working on it. You're dead. Got a sword for your ass. What do you have now? Two GTX 970s. Ooh. Did I fall down or what? Ow. He's down. Whew. Damn, but those Titans are beasts now. Yeah, those Hunters, man. Well, here's the thing is their weak spots are their backs. I'm not really fighting them very well strategically, so it's not really... it would go much easier if I just ran around and attacked them from behind. Now I like to do things from behind, so... I think I'd be good at it by now, but no. Apparently not. There's gotta be a better way.
Got cubbies.
Seek the rogue, does it from behind, hashtags. Nice. Sounds like a pretty uncomfortable seat, just saying. You guys, stop making me laugh. Hey, you guys are silly. You guys are fucking silly, yo. I feel like the jackals have some more personality in this one, too. They're like, blah, blah. Like every time you shoot them.
Clear the area from enemies, Osiris.
Shit's about to get real, yo. So the music in this one is not done by Neil DeVeach, who did Halo 4. It's not done by the gentleman that did the first three Halos either. This is a Japanese composer, I believe, new to the series. Ultimately, I think he did okay, but I'll be honest with you, the soundtrack, although I like it and I like some of the songs in it, don't stand out to me as much as previous Halo games. And I think that was just, you know, they went in a different direction like they tend to do, you know, when they make new games.
Ghost here.
That was one that I like it. It's kind of electronic. It's different. And I'm all for different sometimes, especially if you're telling a different story. The Master Chief has more classical instruments in his themes, so they keep that part going. But then for like the Osiris team, they get a little bit more electronic. And I understand why, like, you know, it's, you know, something when you're like, oh, I'm trying to decipher who a character is and what makes them tick and, you know, who they are as individuals. You make decisions like that, and I just think it's one that doesn't really work for me. Nothing against the team that worked on the soundtrack. They worked their ass off, but it's just didn't work for me. Rogues are not silly. Rogues are incredibly dangerous. Seek the top. Does it from behind, Donnelly. Thank you, Spacefly. I think you know me very well. Everybody knows I am Dr. Doom and the villain, the top, from Flash. And y'all are my bottoms. Oh, shit. I'm just kidding. About the bottom stuff. Don't be offended by that. Y'all are sexy tops. Lose the suspicion. Spacefly, lose the suspicion. I'm fucking him. Good old Assassin's Creed. We were playing Assassin's Creed China, and there was like a dead body. And someone's like, I suspect Zeke is doing something with that dead body in the like, I hid the body in like a, I don't know, like a bush or something. And they're like, I suspect Zeke's doing something naughty with that body. And I said, lose the suspicion. I'm fucking him. You can take it back now. Dallas says, it's on the internet forever. That's okay. I'm sure I've said worse that's on the internet, so it's all good.
I'll notify you when we're ready for extraction.
It must be true, Dallas said. It's on the internet. I tried to shoot him in the air. That didn't work. Shit, look at that. And we got backup from other elites.
Watch the friendly fire. Great distance. Bed can't take
it. Get out of their fire. Yeah. Gotcha. Nice. What a hunter.
Door's opening.
Oh, there he is.
Hunter's down.
Thank you. We're trying. Oh, wait. Joe says to Houston, thank you. Was trying to remember who it was. Joe says Dallas. I saw it on Wiki. That's right, I did too. Must be true. No, hashtag no more hunters. Yeah, it's crazy.
Stand by, Monty. We'll get to the Arbiter soon.
Since Dallas hasn't really seen kind of like the crux of the story, let me just once again give the broad strokes for Dallas, if you guys don't mind.
We're almost there.
So Dallas, this game takes place, Halo 5, takes place 8 months after Halo 4. And actually, you know what? Let me get a drink before I do this, because I can already tell I'm like going to lose my voice. All right. So it takes place 8 months after Halo 4. And you're welcome, Dallas. And basically what happened is after there's been a ceasefire called between the Arbiter and his group of Covenant and Sangheili and stuff, and other elites.
Get in there.
He called a ceasefire, but not everyone has gone with that ceasefire, as we talked about in Halo 4 with Jewel Imdama, I believe is how you say it. And Jewel in Spartan Ops, which is a side game to Halo 4, which we got to play, where you play as Sarah Palmer, because we played Spartan Assault. But Spartan Ops is like a DLC content, and it has Sarah and her crew basically going after Jewel. And they fail in stopping Jewel, and Jewel tries to paint himself to be a new prophet in a way, and kidnaps Halsey, which, you know, I can already tell what Dallas is thinking. Fuck you. but hold on. Houston says, Bungie let him go halfway through the making of Destiny and never announced why. I thought he was one of the best composers for these games. Oh, gotcha. Yeah. Yeah, I agree. I agree. I don't know why Bungie did that either. Voice important. Don't do that. just as a nasty breakup and that lawsuit was not fun. Yeah. Lawsuits are never good. All right, we made it. So Jewel, at the beginning of this game, had Halsey, and he's been using her to help them find, you know, Promethean technology, to help them find, you know, different weapons to help expand, you know, the Jewel's army, basically, and fight back against humans. He doesn't like this ceasefire. All right, well, now we're stuck. Great. That's because of my damn teammates. Bastards. Stupid teammates. They're doing so well. No give backs. You're stuck with Halsey. Yeah. So we as a Team Osiris, this team here, led by Spartan Locke, we have
Eyes on goal. Arbiter! Ready for
There's the Arbiter.
What is the meaning of this?
Here we go. Halsey was taken. She got being tortured because she wouldn't go along with their plans. So Jewel chopped her left arm off. Pretty much from like the bicep down. Totally chopped her arm off to torture her. Made her fall in line. She still found ways to send hidden signals to UNSC to get them to find her. She still tried to help out, but she was also tracking remnants of Cortana. And that's the big thing. So Master Chief, by the way, went back and reunited with his blue team friends from boot camp, which is Fred, Linda, and Tanaka. And the four of them have been going on missions together, but they've been disobeying orders too, and they've been following more of their emotions and not just trying to be blind, you know, guns and weapons. And so Master Chief, at the beginning of this game, gets a vision of Cortana being on Meridian. And he heads to Meridian, and he was getting, you know, saw those messages in the last level. Cortana's contacting him, and his team didn't want to let him go alone, so they went and followed him. So Master Chief and, you know, it's after Cortana. Spartan Locke is one of the newest members of the Spartan program. You could tell he looks just like Luke Cage, because he is Luke Cage, Mike Coulter. The greatest of your clan. And we've been assigned to hunt down the Master Chief. and it's not going well. And now we have Cortana taunting us.
She touched every networked device in the camp. She knows the Guardian is here. Locked.
So she might still be out there, but she may not be the Cortana we know. If it is her. Sorry, can't talk. I'm getting really tired. But if it's even Cortana herself, she may be being manipulated. She might be on her own. It may be a fragment of her that's not trustworthy. There's a lot of different possibilities. Halsey doesn't like that Cortana's still out there and alive, because that's not what AIs are supposed to be. They're supposed to deteriorate after rampancy. So she's a stubborn one, and she's scaring the shit out of everyone, and she's now tapped into the Forerunner technology that the Didact left behind, and she's accessing these ancient weapons called the Guardians, and she's moving them into position like chess pieces, and we don't know why. So now we may have to, you know, battle her. At least that's Locke's point of view. He believes he's at war with Cortana and these, you know, this new threat that she's bringing about with the Wardens and the Guardians. And Master Chief's on his way to try to reason with her, because he doesn't believe she's an enemy. He believes she's still a friend. So that's where these two sides are. So we go back and forth between playing as Master Chief and playing as Spartan Locke. And that's kind of where we are now, is we're desperate and we need to find them. So we're coming to the Arbiter.
It is sabotage.
And now, you know, Cortana has made herself known that she has access to every database in the system. And she's causing some real damage. And she's gaining more power by the second. And she's scaring the living shit out of everyone. That's for sure. Bum, bum, bum. Dallas says, Cortana, best waifu, even when she's a bad girl. Nice. Nice.
This is a constructor.
Well, as far as I can tell, Cortana is telling Halsey to fuck off, so... Yeah, exactly.
Constructors were ubiquitous in Forerunner facilities.
I was trying to punch her. It won't let me.
Support stations for the Sanghelios Guardian. Palmer has the coordinates of one such station.
LOL, Cortana, hashtag Blue Queen. Amen. LOL, I had to look that up to find out if it was a Game of Thrones reference. Nice. Alright, report to Palmer. Where's Palmer at? Over here, okay. So we're gonna go check in with Sarah Palmer, another badass, while our teammates go run around looking for shit. And I am skipping a lot of database things, and there's a lot of secret things hidden in all these levels. I'm trying to, you know, tell you guys in a roundabout way what a lot of those say.
Okay.
I love her armor, though. Pretty dope. And so, yeah, Spartan Locke, he isn't very well liked either, Dallas, because word is getting out there that he has to hunt down Master Chief and stop Master Chief. And obviously Master Chief is a legend. Everybody respects and looks up to him. But you have Halsey, who, you know, doesn't like, she doesn't want John to reunite with Cortana. Because if Cortana is bad, she believes John won't be able to see that she is. He won't be able to pull the trigger. And so she is, even though her actions are kind of dickish, she does have John's best interest at heart, if she even has a heart. Yeah, you tell us, Seek, wait. Nah, I went with the chess reference. That was a gigantic statue. It really was. This Sanghelios is a cool planet. And so, yeah, originally I mentioned in Halo 4 that they are starting a new trilogy called the Forerunner Trilogy. But they've actually changed it. So Halo 6 won't be the end of a trilogy. It'll just be the next chapter in what they now call the Forerunner Saga. Apparently the storyline that they started mapping out is they don't want to try to condense into three games. So it might be four or five. They basically just don't want to put a hold on and a limit, you know. If it takes four or five games to get through what they want to tell, they want to be able to have that option. But now I will say one of the problems with this game is that there's been a lot of rewrites, I guess, if you want to look at it from a movie standpoint. Dallas says Halsey has no heart. She's just a jealous helicopter parent who has no faith in her own program. Hashtag bitch. Damn, Joe says. Tell us how you really feel. Dallas says deeply seated feelings. These grunts are friggin' hilarious. I love the grunts. They're so great. There are actually two grunts back in the city of the main city where we weren't fighting in St. Gilius, where we checked in with Halsey and Palmer. I almost said check in with Palsy. I merged their names together.
Affirmative, Commander.
But you can actually just listen to these two grunts talk for like 8 minutes. It's pretty funny. Yeah, good for them not holding themselves back to three games. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you know, I as a storyteller, I like that, you know, but the problem with this game is that they had a really... Brian Reed wrote the story to this and with the, you know, the 343 team, and he also writes the comic books and some of the tie-ins that came out, like Escalation, some of the Dark Horse comics that came out. And Brian, I think, had a clear story that he wanted to tell. They had so many things in production change, like they do when you're, you know, when you're making a movie or a game, even when you're making comics, things change at the last minute. And one of the things that changed was the Team Osiris. Like originally, if you watch the teaser trailers of this game, I said this earlier, but the first teaser trailer of this game was a cloaked figure walking through the desert, and then a Guardian Awakening, and then the wind blew the cloak off and it revealed Master Chief. And he single-handedly was facing a Guardian, like, all right, I gotta fight this thing. And that changed big time. Because then they came out with the second teasers where Spartan Locke, who, like, just, like, months before they released the second teaser, was actually, like, named Spartan Smith, and then he became Spartan Jones when they made him African-American, I think. And then what they ended up doing, and then they had, like, Spartan, like, Edwards or whatever, and they just had some generic Spartans that they made up, and then they started working on the storyline some more, and then Nathan Fillion became available. They kept trying to get him to do a voice, and he wasn't available. Finally, he became available. And once he became available again, they were like,
focus fire.
There we go.
Shields down.
But once Nathan Fillion came in, they started changing the team around. Then they found Mike Colter and was like, oh, he's perfect for our character. And so there's been a lot of... This game had some development hell going on. It had some problems, for sure, developing. Ultimately, I think from a technical standpoint, they made a beautiful-looking game. Like a really, really looking game. A really good-looking game. But because the storyline, the characters kept changing, it kept interfering with the storyline. So then they went from a storyline where Master Chief was the villain, essentially, and he was being hunted solo. He didn't have his team with him. He didn't have Blue Team with him. It wasn't until they decided to make the game a four-player co-op game that they brought Blue Team in, which was, I think, awesome, because I think it adds more to the character of Master Chief in his emotional state, and it shows them siding with him on an emotional journey. So that's really cool. I'm glad they ultimately did that. I think it opened up the game, makes it feel different than the other Halo games. But it did go through a lot of changes. So this game really, we're probably lucky that it came out even this good. And this good isn't even really, I'm not gonna totally shit on this game. I know a lot of people do, but I like this game. I don't love it. It's not one of my favorite Halo games. But I see the potential in it. I see that if they maybe either stuck with their original vision, or if they could adapt a little bit better, I think they could have. This game could have had a really great storyline to it. I feel. But as much as I can be down on this game, and as much as I do praise Bungie, and I do like them, and I like their, you know, their ability to make really great games and tell good stories, I will put Halo 4 and Halo 5 from a story standpoint, not a gameplay standpoint. I think Destiny is a more fun game to play, but I think story-wise, me personally, I have to give it to Halo 4 and Halo 5. I don't think Destiny has a good story at all. And I think some of the DLCs added some interesting story elements, but then they ultimately just... You know, when they came out with Iron King or whatever the latest one was, they just went right back to telling a bad story. where your character is just, again, power fulfillment. Your character has no personality. They don't really say much. They're just there, and they're there to be you. And that just, I don't know. You can't, when you make it that open-ended, it's hard to tell a coherent, good story with and have a character arc. So your character just stands around and just gets told what to do a lot, and you become a weapon. And much like Master Chief was in the beginning. So I don't really credit Bungie for being good storytellers, but they are fucking awesome at making fun, playable games, for sure. Joe says, Seek shit on games at an AOL Productions film. Dude, I love that you love referencing my A-hole Productions. I love that about you. Like, you're always referencing A-hole Productions. A-hole Productions. I did it in my southern accent. And an A-hole means an adult hobbyist of Lego. That's what A-H-O-L means, for those who don't know. That's what I refer to myself as. And so I came up with A-hole Productions, which is what I make my YouTube show from, which I really need to catch up on tomorrow. So that's why after this level, we gotta stop. I forgot this was a long level. But at the end of this, we're gonna call it a night. Oh, show. Oh hi, doll. Okay, Cunning says. Nice. Welcome back, okay. Yep, Dallas is here. The four horsemen are all here. Well, John Lee's sleeping, so. The four horsemen were almost, well, they're all here technically, but one of them sleeping. War is taking a nap. Joe, after work, constructive criticism is always a good thing, though. Oh, yeah, no. I know. Well, that's why, like, I used to just blindly shit on stuff. But as a editor, like a comic book editor, a storyteller myself, I wouldn't want someone to just shit on the stuff I work really hard on. So I try to be constructive, you know? And I try to really look at what the point of things are when someone makes a game or tells a story, what they were going for. I try to read up on it. If I don't like it, I try to learn a little bit more than just... My days of just blindly shitting on stuff, unless it's I just feel it's really that bad, are kind of behind me. So I try to be constructive. I don't ever mean any harm. And sometimes it's good construction too. It's like, it's good constructive feedback and bad constructive feedback, you know? And it's also just based on opinion. What I don't like in a game, other people are gonna like. So, you know, it's, I always try not to sound like I'm stating a fact. I try to just give it from my point of view. That's always my goal. Hey, Ben5, what is up? Welcome to the chat. I missed your comment, sorry. Feel free to repeat it if you want. I'm so sorry I missed your comment. I saw something changed from 3. That's all I can see. Or is that not Ben? But Ben, if you're here, welcome to the chat. My name is Seek. This is the Seek and Destroy stream. And we're a bunch of nerdy people, and we love making new friends, so feel free to say hi and join the chat if you'd like. And I hope you're having a good day and had a good evening tonight. We're going to be finishing up our stream soon, too, though. This is our last level we're going to play tonight. We're going to play the rest tomorrow. Ben says, I said, wow, Halo has changed from Halo 3. Oh, yeah, dude, is this your first experience with Halo 5? It's pretty dope. Sweet dreams, War. Ah, oh, yeah, get some sleep, War. John Lee is a sleeping horseman. Horseman sleep. The fifth horseman. They're like the seven dwarves now.
Passageway under the shield.
I absolutely love the gunplay in Destiny, but the story was such a shit show. The trailers they had for the game, even a few months from release, had content that was ripped from the game. It was tragic that their writer quit less than 6 months from release. Apparently working conditions and all that other shit was really bad over there. And yeah, a lot of people quit, and there was a lot of drama. A lot of people got fired, and it was just nuts. And then they never rehired anyone. I remember when the DLCs came out, the first DLCs, they were like, "Look, we hired 3 writers, and we got this big story." And man, it was bullshit. I'm like, 3 people came up with this.
Shields down.
Horse manure. Yeah. show's not good. I'm gonna take your fucking wraith down, bitch. Shit. Come here. There you go. Give me that gun. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it. Hide behind the shield. Hide behind the shield. Whew. Oh, hello. Houston said, I'm glad Bethesda hired their gameplay guy, though. Made first person in Fallout so much better. Shows how well a guy can change the game. Oh, absolutely. Abso-freaking-lutely. They did a great job on that. You're dead. Ben says, what is the story in Halo 5? All right, me, I don't want to. All right, I'll tell you real quick. So in Halo 5, let's talk about Halo 4 real quick. In Halo 4, Cortana was dying the entire game. She was suffering from rampancy, which is something that Dallas says again, which is something that all AIs experience after 7 years of being alive. And so while she was dying, she was trying to lead us on this journey. We were frozen out in space at the end of Halo 3, and we were found by us. We were getting signals saying that we were found. So she woke us up from cryosleep, and it turns out what happened was we were actually being tricked into awakening this creature called the Didact, which is a Forerunner. And, you know, obviously playing Halo 1 through 3, you probably know what the Forerunners are. And they're this ancient race that used to be at battle with the Reclaimers, which were ancient humans. So what happened is at the end, we defeated the Didact with Cortana's help. She basically carried most of the weight and kicked a lot of ass. And so, but she ended up dying at the end. And she experienced rampancy, which means she split into every thought she had became its own Cortana. And then they all basically drove each other insane and Cortana died. But she died saving us and saving the world from the Didact. So now the Didact is out there, licking his wounds, hiding somewhere. But his Promethean Knights and his technology ended up in the hands of this guy named Jewel, who is a Covenant leader that doesn't want to follow the Arbiter in the ceasefire with humanity. So he started his own war and his own faction of the Covenant, and is just terrorizing shit left and right. And so what happened is that ever since he did that, he's then kidnapped Dr. Halsey, used her to find other Promethean technology, other Forerunner technology, so he can grow his army. He's calling himself a prophet, even though he's an elite and a Sengili. And he tortured, because Dr. Halsey wasn't having it. She wasn't, willing to just give out information and stuff. So what he ends up doing is he ends up torturing her. He cuts off her arm, and she finally says, okay, I'll help. I'll help you. And so what she ends up doing is telling him where all these technologies are, and they start going across the galaxy finding him. And so Jewel is building his army, and he's becoming more and more of a threat. Well, then what happens is this team here, Osiris team, is sent in to kill him and extract Halsey, because what Halsey's now being forced to do is find remnants of Cortana, and they know how powerful Cortana was in taking down the Didact. So, and what part she played in taking down the Flood and the Covenant, and all that stuff. So she is being sought out after by Jewel. So what happens at the beginning of this game? Osiris team shows up, rescues Halsey, kills Jewel, and meanwhile, while that's going on, Master Chief is sent on a side mission to rescue this, military compound in this base. He does so, but on that mission gets a vision from Cortana. And so now Master Chief has been ordered to stay away from this battle and to let, Team Osiris here take down Cortana, because there's a belief that she might be evil. And she's awakening these ancient Forerunner weapons called the Guardians. And they're these giant, creatures, like these flying metallic creature things. They're pretty awesome. And so Master Chief now is going against orders, and he's looking for the you know, Cortana. And we've been, as Team Osiris, we've been ordered to stop him. So you're playing as two different people in this. You're playing as Spartan Locke, who, that's who we are right now. And you're also playing as Master Chief and showing his journey with Cortana. So it bounces back and forth.
Focus fire on the deck. There's some space and we can land on the Kraken.
So hopefully that answers your question. So right now we are, this Covenant group is now under the control of these Wardens, which is almost like Ultron. The Wardens are these like knights, these Promethean kind of knights, they're badasses. It's one guy, but he has like a million bodies, kind of like Ultron. And he's been awakened by Cortana to kind of protect her while she gains power and recharges, and as she unites all these factions. And but he doesn't trust Master Chief, even though he's ordered to let Master Chief through to meet Cortana. He's testing us. He's testing us against Cortana's wishes and will. But he doesn't ultimately hate us. He just wants to make sure we're worthy, because he holds Cortana in high regards. She's basically his leader. So Cortana is kind of, in a way, the villain of this story. Master Chief is trying to save her. He's trying to rationalize with her. Whereas Spartan Locke has been given strict orders to shut her down and the Wardens and stop Master Chief and bring Master Chief in alive. So a lot of tension going on here. So the enemies are each other, other Spartans in this game. But Spartan Locke is going to be hit a crossroads at some point in the game where he has to make a choice of whether he himself is just a gun, like Master Chief was perceived as. Can Spartan Locke think for himself? Can he disobey an order because he believes something is right? And that's the journey Spartan Locke is on. And if you want to know more about Spartan Locke and his origin, definitely check out the Halo Nightfall movie, which I believe is on Netflix now. And Spartan Locke is played by Mike Coulter, who is Luke Cage from the Marvel Netflix movies or TV shows. So if you like him, definitely check out the Nightfall movie. He plays Spartan Locke in it. It's really a cool movie. And also check out the other movie, Forward Unto Dawn. It's another live-action movie that's really awesome. And that's on Netflix as well. Ben says, man, I missed so much. Holy shit, yeah. This was the Cliff Notes version, absolutely, Joe says. That's definitely the shortest version of that I told tonight, I think. I've said that origin, like, or the like five times, I think, tonight. But so I tried to make it a little shorter each time. But yeah, a lot has happened, Ben, for sure. But I will definitely be here to help you along the way. If you got any questions, let me know, bud. Ben says, wow, yeah, a lot of shit. A lot of shit went down. So this part's hard because I always get lost in this ship.
Generators on the lowest level. Move down.
We're going. Blow up, damn you. Blow up.
Generator off.
There we go.
Get the hell out of there. Kraken's going down.
We gotta go.
Keep going down. Generator should be just below the hangar. Look! Evac, now!
We're going.
I'm clear of the Kraken.
Yeah, but is our team? Come on, team. I'm gonna try to get us to a safe distance so we can watch this. All right. Got a good view from here. I'm almost... it's almost like these Spartan 4s aren't interested in following you. Insubordination.
Victory! Well done, Spartan.
A little bit.
Damn, Osiris, that is
there's a little bit of that.
Kraken's down. Time to grab that constructor. Halsey's coordinates are inside that Forerunner site.
All right, let's go. Bowser says, Ben, I would highly, highly recommend going back and watching all the archive videos of Seek playing through all the Halo games. He has played all of them in the last month or so, and seeing the whole story played out in a short time really helps keep everything coherent. Yeah, and you know what? I think Halo 1 and Reach are no longer in my archives. I think 2, 3, ODST, and 4 still are. Sadly, I did not... There was a glitch on my computer, and it didn't download Reach or 1. So those I won't be able to upload to my YouTube video, which is okay, because that just means we got to play them again. And I will probably play them again, in the coming months, for sure. I will do that. Thank you. Oh, thanks, Ben. For sure.
Where's this constructor we're
at? I'm a big... Halo and Resident Evil are my two favorites. And I definitely try to know as much as I can about both. Now, I will say some things I get wrong. So definitely don't take everything I say with a grain of salt. Some things I get wrong. Some things I mistranslated. Some things I project, for sure. You know, we all get something different out of, you know, everything we do. Movies, games, books. We all kind of project our own feelings onto them. So that, you know, keep that in mind, too. These are all just my opinions. But I do try to capture as much of the lore as I can. For sure. I really do love this universe. I think probably my three favorite universes are Resident Evil, Halo, and probably Star Wars.
See? That's the Guardian there.
But I'm also like a big, you know, Transformer fan. Like I have a lot of favorite things. I love comic books. We're gonna start playing Batman Arkham Knight on Monday. I know a shit ton. I've been reading comics almost 30 years. So there's definitely gonna be a lot of Batman lore. That I'm going to talk about. But Halo is just definitely something that I really, really do love. And I owe a lot to a couple of my friends, Dan and Daniel and Tom in South Carolina, who got me into this franchise. I really, really, really love this universe. But it actually means a lot to me when, like, someone who... you know, really doesn't like Halo 4 and 5, for example. When they watch my streams, I had a couple people tell me, like, hey, I'm not a big Halo 4 or 5 fan, or Halo 4 fan, but your stream kind of turned me around a little bit. And I'm like, that's awesome. Like, I mean, that's not my goal. You know, I'm just trying to share my opinion and why I like stuff, but I gave them a different perspective on what makes the game cool for me. And I like that. That's cool that people appreciated that. Yeah, they appreciate it, you know? Oh, yeah. Nice. Halo 2 is the shit. Yeah, Halo 2 is awesome. Do you have Halo 2 up on YouTube? I don't, but it's gonna go up. It's still available on my I downloaded it, so it's safe. We beat it in one, like, five-hour session, so I'm just going to upload it as one five-hour video. That and Halo 3, which we beat in 4 hours, we're going to also upload that. And you'll see that up probably in the next week on my YouTube gaming channel, for sure. Joe says, sorry, I'm back. Ah, that's cool, man. Played it, but I still recall the gameplay, and it was amazing. Yeah, and we played Halo 2 Anniversary Edition, so we played the upgraded one, which is from the Master Chief Collection. It's good times. And there's a feature on it, like with Halo 1.
Need an assist.
Oh shit, I'm down. Someone get me before he kills me.
Need help.
No worries, Locke. I got you.
Nice.
Thanks.
Don't hide from me.
He's dead. Who's next?
Assassination time.
All clear. Commander Palmer.
Give me your gun. Instructor. I think it's the passion you bring out when you play your games. Well, I definitely am passionate about the games I love, that's for sure. And as a writer, like an amateur writer, you know, writing comics and novels and stuff, these are universes I want to play in. Like, I think Balazar said it when he was like, please Seek, write the Cortana novel. I would kill for that opportunity. Like, I would work my ass off on it. Absolutely. I mean, right now I squeeze in writing, you know, like with Neverland and stuff, and I keep rewriting and rewriting and rewriting with something like that, like a fully paid job like that. And Neverland I take seriously too, because people did donate, and so it is technically it's a paid job. They helped me make it happen. But it's there's a lot to think about with that one, because there's people who want to make it a movie and stuff. So every time I write something, I have to think like on multiple levels of shit, and then I give it to people to read, and they give me notes back, and it's been a much more grueling process than I thought, which is why I don't want to make movies. I'm not that guy. I don't want to make movies. I don't want to write movies. I want to write books and comic books. That's what I want to be, and maybe video games. But Halo is a universe, Resident Evil universe, that I really want to play in. So I try to know as much as I can in case I ever get that call one day. In case one of my, you know, goofy self-published books ever sell a lot of copies, or if Neverland does become a movie, and it, you know, and it makes, you know, helps me make a name for myself in the writing world. When it activates the someone, audience, if I get an agent, they go, "What do you want to write?" I want to say a Halo novel. Cortana, get to it. If you want to keep being my agent, you know. Get me that job. All right, let's go talk to the Arbiter and Sarah Palmer. And thank you, by the way, Balazar, for the social. There's my website, my Instagram, and my YouTube links. If you want to follow me on all those, and if and Ben, if you want to follow me on here, I will definitely replay the Halo games in time. This month we're playing Batman: Arkham Knight and some other games. January is going to be Zombie Month. We're going to play a bunch of zombie games leading up to the release of Resident Evil 7. Then in February, we're going to play some other games like Metal Gear Solid and stuff. Probably in March, we're going to go back to Halo. So definitely follow me on here. And anytime I have an extra night where I could just dick around for an hour or two, I'll probably play Halo and Resident Command, Evil games.
Mission complete. Dr. Halsey has the constructor.
Good work, Osiris.
So for
Once
sure,
Halsey has the
you'll
constructor
see it.
Sorted, Arbiter's people can move on Sinion.
The passion you bring out that makes us want to dive in. Well, these are fun universes, I feel, and I just like sharing. That's one of the reasons I think one of the reasons I got on Twitch was I wanted to share my. It was like when I met you, Joe. Joe and I got flown to Capcom Capcom headquarters up in San Francisco, and we got to play the Lantern demo during the Resident Evil 7 Road Tour, and that's how I met Joe. And who's also a great streamer, Ben. I would highly recommend you following him too. And everyone in here, I'd follow everyone. Everyone in here is freaking awesome. And a lot of them stream as well, and they all have their own passions and their own games that they play. Don't wait for them to call you. See, you will have readers in... thank you, dude. I appreciate that. Ben says, is it just me, or do the things you just killed look like some sort of Forerunner human thing that is just a guess? They are human, actually. We will talk about that after this cutscene. But Ben, they are human. The Prometheans are... Reclaimers that were defeated by the Didact and converted by Forerunner technology. So yeah, when you shoot them, their heads, their metal heads disappear and reveal human skulls that then fade away and break apart. So yeah, they are human. These are super fun universes. That's why I wrote in for Nano Reamer, even if it's unpublishable. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you know? And sometimes, you know, you gotta write because... It's in you, you know, like Dallas understands that too. It's like, I write because it's like a sickness. It's like cutting out. I always say writing for me is, it's like being in a saw trap. And every time I finish a story, I lose a limb. I have to cut my arm off to get through this next story. That's why I don't write as much, but I get really invested. I have to understand the characters emotionally. I have to understand why they're doing things. And I think a lot of thought
say a word or two.
Like that was put into Halo 4 and 5, and I think that sometimes gets lost on people because people don't expect that from Halo. I think they just expect a fun, interesting story where you just run in and shoot shit, and these games try to add something different. And I feel like Halo 5 maybe fails in some of that regard, but I thought Halo 4 did a really good job in that regard. But again, that's just my opinion. And I really hope you make it big out there. You seem like a great guy, and I love your passion for the game you play and want to work in. Also, I hit the follow as soon as I got in. Oh, dude, Ben, you were awesome. Well, I'll definitely follow you back. And that brings us to 96 followers. And Ben, we actually have a deal going on where if I hit 100 followers, when I hit 100 followers, I guess we're so close now that I'm going to play I do a good DMX impression. And we're going to play a game for an hour, and I'm going to be DMX the whole time to celebrate 100 followers. All right.